That's cold in the oil. Do we have a public comment? I believe we have anybody for public comment. I'd like to welcome you to the Northampton Disability Commission. This is our monthly meeting. We didn't have a meeting last month, but we're going to make up for it today. We have.
Gene, I think if you pull your microphone closer to you, it'll actually get some amplification.
Okay.
That would be, is it just recording or is it also?
I believe it's amplification.
No, it doesn't record. It's just amplification.
Or I have not found my lost.
We'd like to welcome our new member here, Jerome.
Hi.
Welcome, Jerome, joining our group.
Thank you, I'm very happy to be here. Thanks, sir.
Once again, we'll call the meeting to order. We have some business to attend. We weren't here last month, but we've got stuff to do. All right. So we'll welcome Jerome as a new member. Did we have a chance to look at the minutes?
These were the minutes of March 19th.
That's correct. The minutes of March 19th.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed with the right sign. So we approve the minutes. Next thing is the mayor is requiring us, many of us, to renew our membership.
Your term is up, yeah.
Yes. And so our terms are up. Oh, this right. It's now. I know some of us have taken care of that. I went up to see the mayor, and he gave me a slip of paper, and we signed it all up, and some of us did. But I want to make sure everybody else is
got there. I can tell you right now, we, for the past 2 months, have had over 100 applicants going on to commissions, boards, and committees. And Jeremy was one that we did interview and approved by four of us on the Committee on City Services, and then sent with a positive recommendation to the City Council and was approved. So everybody, as far as I know right now, that there is nobody else right now coming for us for the month of June to be interviewed again for a reappointment. They're not on our list. We have.
Okay. So if your term is up, you need to reapply if you want to be reappointed.
What they usually do is send you a notice in the mayor's office on reapplying, no matter if you're being reappointed. And a lot of people don't realize this, is that you still have to go through the whole entire procedure. You fill out that application, the mayor sends it to City Council, it is then sent out of City Council to City Services. We have to interview you no matter if it's a reappointment or not. Then you go through the same procedures, you have to go ahead, wait until you get a letter from the city clerk saying that you've been approved, and then you have to go in again and be sworn in, and you still have to take that test.
Stupid.
And,
stupid.
So right now we don't have anybody on our list. Out of 100 people, it's been checked out between the mayor's office and us four counselors who've already been sworn in. So everything so far is up to date with us.
Well, I just want to commend you and the council for, I think Jeremy's experience was much more positive than Emma's.
Yes.
Emma's was, and I don't know what.
Linda.
Linda, what your experience was, but it just seemed this last.
It felt very positive.
Very positive and not overwhelming, which is great. So I also want to thank Jean, who appeared at Judy's in my door with several copies of the paper and made us fill it out there. And that was so helpful.
Yes.
We call it lifestyle coaching.
So all you do is go to the mayor's office and pick up a piece of paper and sign. I gave mine to the mayor, but you can give it to anybody else.
You can also do it online.
Yes, you can.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lou.
You don't have to go into his office.
I submitted an online application.
Yes, that's all.
A lot of people do that.
So I'll mark you off the list, all right? And do you?
I think I'm June, right, to check.
That's right, you did that.
I think the June.
You're aware that you have a t-shirt that has to wear without hurting the seat.
And a very good in the mayor's office, having the updates of who should be coming on an application.
Next item on the agenda is the ADA transitional plan revision and for public forums.
Yes, so what we have to do, as y'all know, this was has now been edited, the update of the ADA self-evaluation and transition plan. We talked about it some weeks ago, but it has been edited. I know I appreciate greatly the work that was done by Marie and by the mayor's chief of staff. I was reassured to open it up and say I actually wrote at least the foundation for some coherent sentences.
Yes,
we did have to eliminate a couple of spots.
You might have understood it, but I didn't.
Yeah,
I don't. Yeah, my level of.
I could have taken 2 pages and explained it. Convoluted sentence.
Just that one sentence, I didn't understand.
At any rate, the situation now is that we have this, and we should move for acceptance today, is the plan that I would propose. With just one proviso, which is to put a picture on the cover, and I have good images posted all, which would also, to some extent, show the renovations that were accomplished by the money we secured from the state, because that was an important part of this.
Can we do it in color?
We can do it in color, absolutely. And on acceptance, I think roughly we should have a press release tomorrow. And then we should also generate a list book of some of the people directly who have been received. I don't know if it's a standard in the city to actually start producing some hard copy. I always feel it's useful to have some people actually get a list book out of it. But I hope that we can work out an outreach plan. Unfortunately, because of Judy's injury, the two of us are going to have to be very, it's going to take a lot of work for us to do the transportation. We have scheduled, Mary Ann has scheduled a presentation before City Council. For June 6th. That's obviously a key date, but let's also generate what would be some other key outreach opportunities. he's spoken specifically about outreaching to the deaf community. That's one of the critical areas of deficiency that we identify in the report. But let's identify some others. I think it would be useful to at least offer a session for not only people in municipal government, but others who might be interested, just entitled to the ADA.
Yes, I was just going to say, how about our district attorney, Dave Sullivan? We have a citizens advisory committee that I'm on, and we do outreach all over. I think that would be excellent.
We're also hoping what we're doing in Northampton to really have some multiplier effects, because we share this information, we share this process with other communities and other
employees.
So that's it. But the first step, I suppose, is to see if we have to move the acceptance of this report. But are there any comments on it? Any sense of any deficiencies or anything you want to put on the record about it?
Chris, I read it on LinkedIn, and I know the paragraphs that you have removed. I would like to make a motion that we move this out of the Commission on Disabilities and removing the ADA self-evaluation and transition plan out of the new update.
That's
a motion to approve.
That's a motion to approve. Is there a second?
Second.
Is there a discussion?
Chris, did you second me?
Yes.
You second.
Is there a discussion? Well, I'll call for a vote. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposing the same side. But the ayes have it. All right. The ayes do have it.
Thank you, Chris.
Thank you so much, Chris. Really appreciate it.
Now, on the plan, the items that we need to do, I had met with, I think we want to use press, first of all. That means a press release that we can do tomorrow.
Yep.
And it gets very, very short. And then, is this usually published online at the time?
Well, it can be put on the city website, yes.
I will get you a couple of other.
Okay.
And we'll publish that. The person I feel most efficient, I wanted to call him, was Wayne at Planning and Sustainability, who's been such an important partner, and it's been Judy's injury that's kind of knocked him back on that, so we can be sure that we have a hard time to Wayne immediately, and then I could generate, I suppose you could generate with you just a list of the folks specifically to have this as well as the general presentation.
Mm-hmm. It might be, I mean, I'm not sure that we can set a date for the first community discussion about it, but we'll issue a press release at that time, but
we
had one set up.
Yeah, no, understood.
Yeah.
It's going to take time for us to figure out how to do it.
Yeah.
The one date we have is June 6th for cast.
Right. Okay. Which is really good because it gives Chris the opportunity of the visibility and the transparency of being video with NCTV and plus our room will be packed again that morning. So people are going to keep up school teachers right down the line. And this is excellent timing because we do have children who disappear.
So it would be useful to have some other council members attend if possible, if you haven't had that joy of coming to the city council. As your recommendations, one of the key recommendations is we have not fully accessible that's available in this council needs. So with that for planning in mind, the council meeting, do you he's going to at least say something very briefly at the public comment, which would be sometime before the actual presentation.
Oh yeah, Jeff, my public comment always comes first. Last 2 weeks ago, it was almost an hour of public comment. Well, because of what's going on with the teachers. So.
I find it always a fascinating exercise in democracy.
It is.
You're on a clock for 3 minutes and you can make comments at any council meeting, and just within the bounds of propriety.
Yes. We cannot speak of open public session. If people are talking to us, councilors, we cannot reply back.
Well, I can speak.
So it's an important means of because there are so many dimensions that fall under this broad perspective. They're not just for this meeting, but it's good to be because they're a part of your engagement in the public process.
Public process, Chris. Because we do have several children and young youths that are disabled going to our schools, if we did an outreach in the schools. Go to each one of the schools. Jordan Kent, Jackson Street, Bird Street, Freedom, and Brian Road.
Are they for him or to tell them about this in council
meeting? I don't know.
To do a community forum.
Right, to do a community forum for the schools. Which you're looking at, like, and how definitely. Ryan Road School, definitely. For our children who are disabled and need wheelchairs and so forth. Leeds, definitely. And we do have part of Hamp School for the Deaf at the Leeds Elementary School. They rent a section of the city, which is really great. So I think it would be something to us to look at of doing community outreach at the schools.
I'm going to do as much as I can. I lost my ability to drive a few years ago, and
Chris, if I know how to drive, I can do it.
But the thing for me, I appreciate Stavros gave me a ride over today. And as I said, as we came in, more than half seriously, I started the organization about 43 years ago. That was the first time I'd ever driven in the Stavros van, which yesterday, is the second time. So I thank them. And one of the things I will ask is what their capacity is. And their van would be a way potentially to during this period that my own driving is limited. So that's fine. One of the key elements, though, is what we've talked about outreach to the deaf community. The person that we both know, he seems to be, I would think, a terrific liaison person potentially to do that, is to ask Rodney and
Rodney Kunath, obviously, and then shortly.
It would be very, very useful to talk to Rodney about would he be willing to take the lead, or who would suggest we have do that, to specifically organize a time and date to do a specific meeting with the deaf community, at which we will be sure we will have sign language interpreters and system.
Right, because he wants to come to City Council on June 6th. Emails in regards about another article you mentioned, and he is looking at an interpreter from Clark School.
Yeah. And Bobby's last name is?
Kunath. K-U-N-A-T-H.
It's
you have his email address, right? I'll send it to you.
I don't think I do, but
because maybe you could ask him.
And I suppose it should be noted that the school has been in the news significantly in dealing with the difficult episodes of its own history that were in the days of oralism, before sign language was appropriately admitted for which that Northampton had a very, very, in some ways, ugly history in the schools that went on staff. And I expect that that bit of history is more than a little bit of the discussion we want to have with the day.
I'll email Rodney tonight because he does work at the collegiate, but I'm not sure if he's still on second shift or not. I'm not positive. I think he might work 3 days a week or four. Because he wanted me to meet with him on Tuesday night. I couldn't because of what I did.
And we'll see what works within Rodney's schedule, but he's a really key person. And like I said, if the scheduling could be worked out, I'd love to see him apply.
I think it will be difficult for him to
do. Or have him give us a good recommendation. Maybe to do successful.
Yes.
Someone else is very important in this community.
Yes.
This has been one of the worst.
He's been in the notice for that. He's been arguing constantly about close action. But maybe what I could do is set up something with this, like Rodney, get a schedule for him and come over to your house.
That'd be wonderful, yeah. We could show Rodney video of Rodney talking to Maura Healy when she was first in the day,
right,
about the need for action.
Let me talk to him. And I'll have him give me some dates and check out with you.
Great.
I'm going to try to know the agenda is accessibility fair, okay.
So, you might all remember when Ben Kalish came to the meeting to talk about the accessibility fair that we were co-collaborating to create. And they have since decided to not do it because there is one being planned for the region that's going to be very large. So, so I think that they're going to watch what happens with that one, and then if they feel like there's a need to expand on that in some way, we'll do it locally. But so, but it sounds like it will be very informative. So.
Do you know where it's going to be?
I can send you the information. They did let me know. They are doing a lot, I don't know if people have noticed, but they're doing a lot of workshops at Forbes. And it's inspiring. I think it's really, they're doing a lot for the community.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I will forward information on that.
Yeah, Forbes is our one of our communication hotspots.
Yes.
Lot of good work and a lot of good process.
Mm-hmm.
And so,
there you go.
Have Forbes be one of our partners.
Definitely. Yeah. Yeah, and I think going to different parts of the city, housing developments, and things like that, so we're getting a broad,
mm-hmm.
broad audience.
I agree.
So,
which moves us right into new business. Is that, yes?
I have a couple of things. One is this question. I understand there's been a very significant acknowledgement of the last part as awarded.
I think we got that message from the mayor. Sorry, I think that's a little bit, we got some of the, we need to have a contact with us.
Recently?
No, I think a couple months ago.
I thought we saw a notification, right?
Just recently?
We may have seen one, we may be out of date. But it's very significant because, again, the $250K we secured, to our great surprise from the state.
There was something on Facebook about that from the mayor.
You know, that is certainly part of the story that goes with this. And we were looking and made application to the state to extend beyond the borders of Pulaski Park, which was the pedestrian environment that ran over to City Hall.
I think it's on the mayor's Facebook, on the mayor's page, city website. It was an excellent article.
And again, I think it reflects tremendously on some, I don't know who was specifically involved in that project, but you always suspect that it was at the heart of it. You've done just a terrific job, and we would not be where we are today. I think as we go out to the community, we want to tell this, you know, as a story, that if this is just in the 13 more by company recommendations, sit down and wait. But it's, you know, that this is relevant to different constituencies in the city. Your experience with struggling with snow accessibility, we at least try to reflect that.
Definitely. And I'd like to let them know that I'll reach you. Spread the word.
I have to say thank you, Jeremy, because when we were doing Jen Ash and I, Councilor Ash and I, we're doing a site visit together at Roberto's,
right?
Who's coming down but Jeremy? I goes, oh, Jeremy.
Yeah,
and he was fantastic. You know, he saw the sites, and right off the bat, he agreed with what I was saying of the danger on that other side. And then we all met again for the second time. Chris and Bree brought up, and Judith, and everybody here. I want to thank you.
Yeah, of course. I want to say.
Good timing.
Yeah,
perfect timing.
Yeah.
I think you wanted to add.
Yes, yes. Okay, question. If you can recall the 2 months ago, we took off 1 month in the summer.
Yeah.
Do you remember if it was July or August? I can't remember.
Well, probably it was just August. It might have been August, yeah, I think it was last year, but yeah, it probably was.
Does everybody agree about having 1 month off for the summer, or August?
August is vacation month.
Right, vacation.
Yeah, meeting formally, if we had defined some event, it would not include our year event that was set for this year.
Is there a motion to that effect?
We said a motion that this year the Disability Commission will meet in August.
Second.
Those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, the same sign? You're not going to meet in August.
We got a vacation. Thank you.
Another point in the business. I had a meeting over across the river in Cameron. And this is a program through Starless. I did describe it all the same about that organization. But one of the really very fun things that they do is a program for home modifications. This is to support, it's been considered installation of grants. And that's the circumstances where the household has no eligibility for other funds. It's a program that's trying to do some private fundraising to support that. You will see some of those grants as well. It's good program. It also links with something we've discussed before, which is they also have a program. It's now multiple organizations in the state work together to recycle equipment like wheelchairs, any of the adaptive equipment. It's been a very strong program. It's been our wheelchairs, refurbishing them. And those two work together. Grant and some other small entry modification programs and recycling equipment. Here's what we threw out. As we know, this new industry has developed most brilliantly over here in the last few years. I don't know what the discussions are, Marianne, in terms of how new revenue would be used. But it was basically both to ask NEDA about its involvement. We know that senior administrators that receive services are there for their own children to stop this. But whether consideration might be given within municipalities, at least to talk about a relationship with some small percentage of this. It would be put into a flexible pot to be used within the municipality, and then we could start to define criteria for those critical access interventions. Very often, like somebody has experienced, if Judy and I did not live in a thoroughly accessible and very spacious home, then the injury she had could be immediately compounded. Badly broken leg. A 69-year-old woman would be sent home with a massive fracture and securing on crutches. To be able to call up and to say this as quickly as possible, like the schedule for, it might be the handrail to help you get up those stairs safely, or some other, but I think that is worth an exploratory discussion about the relationship between the dispensary, the municipality, and the independent building center.
And what?
And the independent building center, and salaries.
But it would be affiliated if you're saying the municipalities of the city of Northampton.
And then they could try to develop some relationship.
I like that idea.
And I'm just talking about an exploratory discussion. It's a new idea. And no doubt, of course, there are many concerns about how these new revenues can be used. But it can also be a point, potentially, about our evolution of the community. What are the impacts that we know from uni very well? But you attention is there something that these monies could be appropriately used essentially in a partnership? So then I think that's not a motion, that's just
no, but I think that's an excellent idea. I would really like to be part of that. I think it's in dire need. Just knowing residents that I know that have had a stroke and could use access of something like that. I have a lot of people on my board who do have a grants
program. Yeah.
I'd like to go. Marie, you and I, Shane, whatever.
Well, we'll have them come over here and that the person who basically initiated this fundraising effort for Martin, who was the first director of service many, many years ago, and is doing it now as a private philanthropy.
I
feel sometimes disconnected there just across the river, and now I've just gotten this great support from my old gang. So let's see if we can do it.
I also like the part about the reusing part, recycling like wheelchairs and that. We have a reuse right there at the landfill on Glendale Road. There it's amazing what some of the staff do there. People bring in things, tables over, everything like that.
And I also would like to specifically have a certain Northampton radio personality post. Both something which we would discuss with this and maybe talk about some of these other areas that we want to engage in.
Is there further new business? Is there a motion to adjourn? Motion made and seconded. Those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed with a light sign, it's been adjourned.